Learn English online with wowlessons.com, created for you, inspired by you.
Are you worried about your IELTS listening module? Don't worry. In this video, I'm going to share with you some easiest and most effective tips to get highest scores in the IELTS listening section. So let's get started. Improve your general listening skills. The goal of the IELTS listening section is to assess your listening skills. Do not use practice tests as a sole source of improving your listening skills. That's not enough. It will help you become more familiar with the test, but in order to improve your listening skill, you will have to do more than going through practice tests. It is better to spend some time in the months before the test to do various listening exercises. Listen to BBC radio station and podcasts, or watch some quality content. With these exercises, your listening skills will improve a lot. Polish your vocabulary. Section 3 in the listening module is all about education. For example, students and tutor talking about an assignment. Learn the relevant vocabulary about studying at the university. This way, you will understand this section better, and in the exam, your performance will increase or improve because of your familiarity with the relevant vocabulary. When you have to answer multiple choice questions, remember that the information might be expressed in different ways in the recording. Listen to the ideas, not particular words or phrases. Try to get an idea of the situation. Before each part, you will be given a short introduction. This introduction is not written anywhere, so be attentive. Note who are the speakers, why are they speaking, and where are they. This way, you will make your understanding about the rest of the recording much easier. Do not lose attention. Keep in mind, you will only hear the audio once. So if you did not hear some words and passed over some questions, don't worry. Leave them blank and focus on the actual part. Review those questions at the end of the section. Otherwise, you will only miss more questions and get confused in the recording. Remember, you will need to read, write, and listen all at the same time. The accent of the speakers on the tape are primarily British. This means you must become accustomed to understanding the nuances of such accents. If you have been watching a lot of American television shows such as Friends, for example, it will not really help you. British accents are quite different, and it is better to spend some time in the months before the test listening to British radio stations, podcasts, or watching the BBC news. This is one of the major differences between IELTS exam and the TOEFL, which features more American accents. Learn to distinguish opinion from the fact. In the third and fourth listening passages, you will probably be tested on what one of the speakers thinks or what his or her opinion view is. This may or may not be stated outright, but as an underlying thing in the whole conversation or in the tone of the speaker's voice rather than the words themselves. Follow the instructions very carefully. If the instructions state, write no more than 3 words, then you must not write more or you will receive no marks for your answers, even if some of the words you wrote were part of the correct answer. Similarly, read each instruction very carefully. Sometimes you are asked to circle 2 answers, sometimes 3, and so on. You must read the instructions each time, as it may differ from the previous ones. Keep in mind, the ability to follow the instructions in English is a test in itself. Familiarize yourself with charts, graphs, flowcharts, bar charts, and pie charts, etc. When you have to complete a flowchart, remember to listen for sequencing words such as then and next as they help you understand the stages of the process. These often appear as a part of the answer choices in the fourth section. The more comfortable you are with interpreting the data represented in them, the easier your exam will be. Always keep a watch for silly mistakes. In IELTS listening exam, when you have to complete sentences, make sure that the words or phrases you write is correct both in terms of meaning and in terms of its grammar. If you make a mistake in the spelling while writing it down, you may get the answer wrong. After each section, you have 30 seconds to check your answers. At the end of the listening test, you will have 10 minutes for transferring your answers into the answer sheet. Quite often, students get confused in the numeration. As you write down your answers, check that they fit into the correct numbered space. In other words, make sure that the answers for question number 7 goes into space number 7. Last tip of the video, you will not lose marks for incorrect answers. So even if you don't know the answer, it is better to write something in the box. Read the question again and make a guess. I hope these tips will be helpful for you. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Like it if you enjoyed it. Use the comment section if you have any questions related to this video. Share this video with others who need this. And in the end, don't forget to subscribe to our channel in order to get more videos like this. Thank you.